Hey everyone, I'm Cubastic and I love solving puzzles, and probably hundreds or even thousands of puzzles have passed through my hands. And today I have a pretty interesting one on my desk. This is one of the most difficult puzzles with the smallest number of elements. There are only 5 tricky shaped elements that we need to place in a white frame. I have already solved a similar one where it was necessary to place 7 similar elements in a rectangular frame. That puzzle was called 7 waves. I also printed it like this one with a 3D printer. And based on this experience, today I will try to solve this puzzle, reveal its secret and show its wall essence in the least amount of time. I printed this puzzle with a new 3D printer which was sent to me by the company called Anycubic, many thanks to them. The model is called VIPER and this printer has a fairly large printing area, 245x245x260mm. And by the way, this is the largest 3D printer in my collection. Yeah, I already have a collection of 3D printers. The VIPER is equipped with a volcano nozzle, it's so long, and this means that the hidden area will be larger and the printing can be done faster or in large volumes. I'll try sometime later. After assembling this printer and taking a closer look, I found a secret toolbox. There are some helpful, useful things in it, but I will probably hide something in it, so that Oxy doesn't find it. It's time to turn on the printer and print something with it. I didn't figure out at the beginning which side I should put the metal plate on the magnetic pole, flat or rough. Well, let's pretend it's double-sided. On other printers, by the way, the calibration of the table is done manually, but in the case of a VIPER, it is configured independently using supersensitive electronics. The nozzle goes through 16 points on the table and that's it, perfectly smooth. The first printing, by the way, was this owl. For the first time, it seems to be good. But I had to make a few more test prints in order to find the right settings for other types of plastic. And now that the printer is set up perfectly, I can start making the puzzle itself. That is the most important part of this video. Right now I will be using the timer, but write in the comments how long you think it will take me to cope with this puzzle, taking into account my great experience in solving different complicated puzzles. Let's go! Let this video be a guide on how to solve any puzzle. After all, many of you know that rather difficult puzzles have really tricky secrets, tricky ways to solve them, and the most important thing to do is not to try play the rules of the puzzle. Here, the puzzle wants us to place the elements within the frame in a similar way, right? See? You can ideally match these elements, for example, in this way. Yes, you can see that the details are perfectly matched here, but I think that you shouldn't be led by this puzzle and we should solve it in some unusual way. Last time the secret was that some of the pieces were horizontal and some were this way. For example, here, parts can go in this way and then, for example, we can act in this way. So the detail, as you can see, is not horizontal. We can come from this position to this, and this bit is used for such a task. Here you can try to do the same, but unfortunately none of these details fit together. You can check several solutions and try to do it in some way. By the way, look, it's pretty easy. If it fits in here, it will be pretty funny. No, of course it won't fit here, and although there is literally half a millimeter of free space. You can try to work in this direction, but it seems to me that there is an even more cunning solution here. For example, placing the parts somehow diagonally. Why not? We can try. But I am 100% sure that there will definitely not be the most simple and obvious option here. It is also really important to take into account in general the huge number of combinations that can be added with only 5 elements. For example, an element can be framed like this. Upside down is already 2. We can also turn it over with the other side and place it in any plane like that. So it can be this way, and vertically, and diagonally. So there are lots of options here, and there are 5 elements, all their combinations possible here. And it is rather difficult to calculate them. So let's try to figure out if we can fit 5 of these parts in this way. So this is how it fits perfectly, the detail is included in the detail. Well, it's pretty good, look how we're doing it. This is another non-standard way to solve this puzzle. Even then, we would not be able to solve it, even if we find the perfect position for the remaining 2. Anyway, this place here is not enough to accommodate some of the details. Therefore, we won't use this option. If you understand that the solution will not succeed in this case, then you don't need to move on and on. And another trick that I often use in puzzles like this is to try to solve the puzzle outside the frame. This way we will postpone it for now and see how in general these details can be combined. Now it is not important for me to combine them perfectly even. Now I just want to understand how they can move relative to each other. Just for the sake of interest, I want to understand if the details fit in this way. If we put one here, and the rest will be placed between them. Yeah? Enough space, I see it's close, but enough. I don't think this is any of the correct options, but nevertheless quite a lot of free space will remain. Maybe it is worth acting in one of these modes, but since it fits pretty tight here, I don't think that's right. But it looks pretty nice. And a lot of free space, as you can see, but we understand that this is a deliberately wrong option. Most of all, I'm thinking about some kind of a diagonal option. For some reason, what I want most is to try to do this way. Guys, subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications. In one of the following videos, I will show you and try to solve a really difficult and nice looking puzzle printed on a 3D printer. Don't miss it. I already had this option. For some reason, I came to it again. Okay, back to the way I originally thought about. Let's put together something that looks like something correct out of the box. Basically, since we need to save space, we need to somehow place them as tightly as possible. For example, here is such an option. Basically, it looks like something right. I think we're pretty close. But again, that damn millimeter is missing. Okay, let's try not to separate these details, because I think they are just made for each other. Let's leave them. Whoa, that's pretty good. Look, if we take one of them, put it here, and try to put another one somehow. We have two pieces that fit perfectly in pairs. This may be an option, or this may be an option. And here we can have this option, or this one. If we can, if we try somehow combine all these options with each other, then it will... wait a minute. That is how it could be placed. Pretty good. What should I do about these similarities in the details? The fact that they can, like this, like a zigzag, lie down right on the edge. Like this option. And so far I like this option the most, but the question is what to do with the last one. One more diesel has joined. Let's try to place two blocks somehow. First, second, again use some diagonal options. It seems to me that now I am as close as possible. This is how it should fit. Yes! Stop! That's brilliant! Great! This is amazing! Awesome! Guys, I've always said that any puzzle requires some kind of logical intervention and out-of-the-box thinking. If we acted exactly as the puzzle told us to do, then we certainly wouldn't have come to the correct result. And in advance, if we proceed from the fact that you need to act outside the box, you can quickly come to a decision. I did it in exactly 25 minutes. Who wrote it in the comments? Well done! I'm so happy that I printed it with a 3D printer. It's so cool! So you can subscribe to the channel and watch videos about 3D printing there, as well as solving different exciting puzzles. So guys, that was Cubastic, bye everyone and have a good time!